For the first time in a week, South Australia has recorded no new cases of COVID-19, but authorities are tonight warning people to remain on high alert.
Our newest drive-through clinic swamped as soon as it opened. 1,300 people swabbed across the state in just 90 minutes, following a record 24 hours.
South Australians answering the call, desperate to stave off a second wave. Hundreds streaming into Victoria Park's Pitt Lane, our newest drive-through clinic, some waiting well over an hour.
I think it's important regardless of, yeah, you know, how long it takes, as long as you're doing the right thing, that's the main thing.
The state recording no new cases today. Authorities also relieved to learn one of yesterday's two positive tests was actually negative. The initial result had officials on edge, with no link to other known patients.
These testing platforms are not infallible. We have, in numerous cases in this pandemic so far, sent a test off to be tested again.
It means there's currently 8 active cases of COVID in the state. With arrivals of essential travellers continuing to touch down from Melbourne, there's a fresh push to put any Victorian coming here into forced hotel quarantine.
And we should be following what other states are doing in mandating supervised quarantine arrangements.
A request to take another charter flight in coming days also knocked back.
We have indicated that we have a limit that we can accommodate within the resources we have, and I wouldn't imagine we would exceed that limit.
A record day of testing yesterday expected to be topped again. Long waits seen in the north and south, with a new clinic to open at Aldinga tomorrow, while a new heavy vehicle testing station has opened at Tailem Bend.
We're adding to our testing capability, getting extra staff available, so we are trying to meet the demands that we need to meet for South Australia.
A doctor's referral isn't needed for a test at Victoria Park, unlike the two other metropolitan drive-through clinics.
We're close to being able to remove the GP referral requirement from all of the other clinics.
Testing here in Victoria Park is just wrapping up for the day. The clinic will reopen at 8 a.m. tomorrow. Now, for people who are coming down, they need to be either in their car or on a motorcycle to get a test. They're not taking walk-ups. Authorities continue to review our restrictions with the potential to tighten them further. A lot will depend on how many cases are found. Brenton, any changes aren't expected to be revealed until Friday.
Rory McLaren, thank you for the update. Concerns tonight about the spread of the virus and the chance of more restrictions here seen panic buying return to local supermarkets. Mike Lorigan has spoken with local operators and Mike Summer taking immediate action.
Yep, they are, and the situation is serious enough for Drake Supermarket in Adelaide to reintroduce limits on toilet paper, 2 packets per customer per transaction. And this is a preemptive measure by Drake Supermarket, given what we've seen in major retailers and supermarkets across Adelaide today. There is big runs and big sales now on essential items. We witnessed bare shelves in a number of supermarkets, suburban supermarkets today. Some still had limited stock, like here at Drake's, but they are a long way from full. It follows a nervous couple of days after a cluster of cases here in South Australia, and of course the worsening situation in Victoria. But the South Australian Independent Retailers says panic buying is completely unnecessary.
There's enough to go around. Just shop like you normally do. And if you see any of this unscrupulous behaviour and you think there's something going on with hoarding and groups of people doing it, for God's sake, dob them in.
Now, of course, it is very important to note this isn't like what we saw at the start of the pandemic, but retailers are urging customers and people to please show some restraint.
Mike, thank you.